There was actually a baseball diamond here back in the 1860s. There was a club that was one of the first professional clubs in St. Louis that organized in 1875 called the Brown Stockings. If you consider the fact that both the American League Browns and the National League Cardinals played here until, from 1920 up until 1954 when the Browns moved to Baltimore, think of it. You had two major league clubs playing here. You could come any Sunday and see a ball game. You could see every star in the American League and every star in the National League right here.
It was really a unique place. I loved watching Musial hit those balls out of right field. They had the screen there up, or taken down, one year. And then when I go to the games with the Browns, a couple of my buddies and I, you know, they had the knothole gang. Well, we were crazy. We climbed up like 50 feet to get into the park one time, and we got in, and there were not too many fans going to the Brownie games, and we'd get in the stands, and we would know where the foul balls were going. We must have had 10 or 12 baseballs, and about that time, this usher comes up and grabbed us by the neck and said, "Give me the balls, you're out of here." All of a sudden, here comes Bill Veeck. He says, "Hey, leave those guys alone, let them go, and give them the baseballs." So I'll never forget that about Bill Veeck.
There have been many, many great events happen here, but one of the most important would be the 1944 World Series. It was the first time an entire World Series was held west of the Mississippi. It was between the St. Louis Cardinals and the St. Louis Browns. And the entire series was played at the same ballpark. And that's the last time that ever happened.